So welcome to Open Levels Vinyasa. Go ahead and take a comfortable seat. Siddhasana is preferable. Hips elevated on a blanket. The knees roll out and go heel to heel. And go ahead and move the buttocks flush out and back. Feel the sitting bones ground down into the floor. And let's place the hands in Dhyana Mudra. So the hands will rest in the lap, left palm up, back of right hand in the left palm, tips of thumbs together. If you identify as a male, however, it's the right hand on bottom in the left, back of the left hand in the right palm. And, you know, all gender dogma aside, you can switch crossing a couple times and see which one feels the most resonant with you. That actually might be indicative of, you know, what nadi you're flowing through, Ida or Pingala, yin or yang. Okay. So Dhyana Mudra, tips of thumbs together, rest the hands in the lap, elongate upwardly and allow the eyes to close. Just land, go ahead and exhale the air. And then as you inhale, inflate the belly, expand the side ribs, let the heart open wide with breath. And as you exhale, roll the breath down the ribs and draw the pit of the belly back at the very bottom of that. Inhale calmly now, inflate the belly, expand the side ribs, inflate the heart wide. Exhale, roll the breath down the ribs, channel it to the pit and pull the pit of the belly back. Make sure the thumbs are pointing up, not out. They're pointing up towards the heart here. So you have a circular pattern, but the tips of the thumbs are together, not the pad. There's nothing aggressive about this engagement. The hand should rest. Let the thumbs soften, but don't let them drop. Just continue to deepen your breathing. Start to channelize ekka grata, or one pointedness. So in any given moment, we're moving from a distracted, disturbed, or restless state. And we start to channelize that energy, that prana, into one pointedness, into a single pointed focus. And the way we channelize this through yogic technique is initially through the breath. So you can sit still all you want, but unless you have breath awareness, that ekka grata usually is not going to come in. So keep noticing the breath and start to find ujjayi pranayama, initiate it with an exhalation. And then as you inhale, hear the audible aspirate sound coming from the back of the throat. And likewise, as you exhale, audible aspirate sound coming from the back of the throat. And let this ujjayi breath be comprehensive. So it's not one dimensional. As you inhale, feel the ribs expand in every direction. Feel them stretch wide out and back. And as you exhale with ujjayi, feel the ribs hug in and down. And then you just repeat this ujjayi inhale, ribs stretching wide out and back. Exhale, ribs hug in and down. I'll take a few more ujjayi breaths. We are in Dhyana Mudra, if you just arrived. And take a moment and just channelize an energy that you want to cultivate in your practice. So some of us are actually looking to advance the physical layer because of how it clears our energy field. Some of us are looking to heal some emotional quality and anything in between. So just call something to heart that feels resonant today. What do you want to bring into your energy field, into your physical body through the vehicle of asana and pranayama? In your own way, let's dedicate practice towards that. And then it will be up to you to remain in one pointedness towards that energy, no matter what arises. See if you can dedicate your attention fully. So this is the opposite of being scattered. This is like an arrow aimed at its target and going straight there. The Bhagavad Gita says, like a lamp in a windless place that does not flicker. That is the figure used to describe the mind of a yogi meditating on the goal, on the Supreme Self. So let your mind become solid and clear like that, luminous. Take one more breath here. Exhaling. As you inhale, fold the palms into prayer at heart center. Exhale all of your air. Three long ohms. Inhale. A deep breath. Keep your palms folded as you exhale. So we will chant the Gayatri mantra, one round call and response, and one round all together. The mantra's in the chat if you need a visual cue. This is a relatively easy mantra. This is a mantra to invite the divine or the energy of God into our life and help us embody that. It's also a dedication to the sun. So saying, may this light of the divine come into my field and radiate outwardly in every direction without discrimination. Okay, call and response first. Here we go. Listen, and then I'll call it back with you. Om Bhur Bhuvah Svah. Together, inhale. Om Bhur Bhuvah Svah. Tat Savitur Varenyam. Tat Savitur Varenyam. Bargo Devasya Dimahi. Bargo Devasya Dimahi. Diyo yo na prachodayat. Diyo yo na prachodayat. Now one round all together. Inhale to start. Om Bhur Bhuvah Svah. Tat Savitur Varenyam. Bargo Devasya Dimahi. Diyo yo na prachodayat. Inhale for Om. Deep breath. As you exhale, release your palms and blink the eyes open. Release your knees. Come on to all fours as you're ready. Take your time. That was a good sit. So transition to all fours. And again, don't rush. We have time. Okay. Fix my camera. So set the mudra of the hands, everyone. Like, make that the first priority since your hands are one of the major bases here. Fingers flare out nice and wide. Tone back the pit of the belly. Now keep your core stable. So we call this neutral pelvis. Ground your fingertips. And as you inhale, rock forward a little bit. Try to bring your shoulders past your fingertips. Push the heel of the hand down. Be gentle, opposite of overdoing it, right? Scoop the belly in. Inhale. And then exhale, rock back. Keep your hands glued to the floor. Drop your buttocks onto your heels. So it's like a half child's pose. And then do it again. Inhale, rock forward. Bring the shoulders past the fingertips. Let the buttocks drop a little, but not the core. Exhale, rock back, reach the buttocks towards the heels. Keep your head lifted. Good, do it again. Inhale, rock forward, shoulders past the fingertips, anchor the roots of the hands. Exhale, rock back, drop the buttocks onto the heels. Good, one more, inhale, rock forward, hold it. Now hold it in a way that doesn't hurt. So if you can't go super far forward into wrist extension, you don't. Anchor the heel of the hand. So feel the stretching in the forearm flexors. Feel it like crow pose. And then as you exhale, start to shift back, drop your buttocks onto your heels. Your shins are parallel to one another. And then keeping your buttocks on your heels, crawl your hands forward into active child's pose. So keep the hands rooted, let your head drop onto the floor. Let your elbows stay lifted unless you cannot. And take a few long, prolonged breaths here. Today's class is going to be probably a little bit of a stronger practice because the group is here in full force now. And it's a nice day to give thanks for life. So let's breathe deeply here. One more big breath. And then as you inhale, look between your hands, shift your shoulders over your wrist and come into plank position, curl the toes under and lift the knees off the floor. Tone back the pit of the belly over and over. Make sure your hands are set intelligently and then do the same thing. Rock your shoulders over your fingertips. Come onto the tips of your toes, the tippy toes. Feel this deeper core activation. And then as you exhale, rock back into down dog. Ground your heels or not. And then do it again. Ripple forward into high plank. Rock your shoulders over your fingertips, tips of the toes. Exhale, rock back, down dog. Good, inhale, ripple forward, high plank, shoulders over the fingertips, tiptoes. Exhale, rock back, down dog. And one more time, inhale, rock forward, shoulders over the fingertips, tips of the toes. Hold it for five, tips of the toes. Four, lengthen the sides of the neck. Three, feel your core. Two, exhale, downward facing dog. Step your feet forward an inch or two so you can manage this. And then just find a little bit of free form movement, perhaps rocking the hips side to side, pawing the hands on the floor like a cat pawing the rug. Welcome, Chris. Push through the hands. Prolong the breath. And graduate to center here in down dog. Let your head hang. Lift your heels off the floor, bone straight arms, tiptoe the feet forward. Bring the feet just behind the wrists. And then fold forward. And instead of doing ragdoll fold, let's keep the hands on the floor, hinge right at the hip crease and let the head hang. You can bend the knees a little or a lot, or none at all if it's easy for you, meaning your belly's on your thighs. Reach your hands back and interlace your hands behind your back. Keep it slow and gentle. Reach the knuckles up to the sky and reach the arms over the head. Now here, once your shoulders settle, try to wiggle the shoulders side to side. So glide with the knuckles, move the knuckles one way, roll the shoulder back, right? So say you move your hands to the right, roll your left shoulder onto your back. Move your hands to the left, roll your right shoulder back. So do it just a few times. So trying to work a little deeper into the bind. And once it feels like enough, go ahead and hold it. Keep hugging the shoulder blades towards the spine. Keep reaching the arms overhead. Scoop the pit of the belly back. Inhale. Exhale, lower the hands to the floor, fingertips in front of the toes. Big halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, heel toe the feet together. Inhale, lengthen again, make a flat back. And then fold, slide your hands alongside your feet and drop your head. Elongate and rise up, circle the arms overhead, join the palms together and see the thumbs. Exhale, samasthitihi, equal standing pose. Inhale, arms overhead, see the thumbs. Exhale, swan dive forward and fold, palms down, head down. Inhale, halfway lift, set for plank and mindfully step into plank as you exhale. I want you to take an extra breath, find your midline. Next, exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Hold the first one more than one breath. Feel mula bandha kick into action. Roll the bottom of the sacrum down. Externally rotate the shoulders. Puff the chest and lift the chin. Exhale, tone back the pit, downward facing dog. Shorten it out an inch or two, 5 breaths. Gaze between the thighs. 1, hug your fingertips down. 2, hug the forearms in. 3, lengthen the sides of the neck. 4, ujjayi breath. 5, lift your heels, tiptoe forward, get there in 1, inhale, halfway lift at the top. Exhale and fold. Inhale and rise, arms circle overhead, palms together, see the thumbs. Exhale, samasthitihi, equal standing pose. Inhale, arms overhead, see the thumbs. Exhale, swan dive forward and fold. Inhale, halfway lift, set the hands for plank. Exhale, step back and take chaturanga. Inhale, up dog, flare all 10 toes. Exhale, downward facing dog. Shorten it out an inch or two. And a good idea when you're doing that is lead with opposite foot each time, because most of us are asymmetrical, always leading with the same foot. 1, breathing deeply. 2, reach your outer hips up and back. 3, anchor the root of the thumb. 4, upper arms roll out and back. 5, lift your heels, lead with opposite foot, tiptoe forward. Get there in 1, inhale, halfway lift. Exhale and fold. Inhale and rise, arms circle overhead, see the thumbs. Exhale, samasthitihi. 1 more. Inhale, arms overhead, see the thumbs. Exhale, swan dive forward and fold. Inhale, halfway lift, set for plank. Exhale, step opposite foot back first, take chaturanga. Inhale, up dog, anchor the index finger. Exhale, downward facing dog, leading with opposite foot, shorten it out a little, big breath. 1, stay 1 pointed. 2, conducting yourself as if we were all in the same room together. How would you hold yourself then? 3, that is exactly how you should proceed. 4, lengthen through the side waist. 5, lift the heels, leading with opposite foot from last time, tiptoe forward. Big halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Elongate and rise, arms overhead. See the thumbs. Exhale, samasthiti. Good. Step your feet back about a foot from the front edge of the mat. That way, if you choose to jump into chaturanga, you have the territory for it. Okay, humble warrior salutation. Interlace your hands behind your back. Bring the knuckles to the sacrum for a moment. Roll the shoulder heads back. Squeeze the elbows back like you're going to clamp a block between your elbows. Keep the heart wide. Pull the hands off the seat. Roll the buttocks down and make a baby back bend. And even if you could go much deeper, just don't. Lift the heart high. Inhale. Exhale, bend your knees and sit into a chair. Keep the interlace lifting off your seat. Move your sternum forward. Inhale. Keep your interlace. Exhale, fold over your thighs. Bring your belly to your thighs. Maybe straighten the legs. More than one breath while we learn it. Inhale. Exhale, release the palms to the floor. Set for plank. Step or float back into chaturanga with next exhale. Inhale, up dog, pull through. Exhale, downward facing dog. Step the right foot in a little. Inhale, reach the left leg up. Three-legged dog. Exhale, step your left foot forward. Step the back foot out to the right about an inch and spin the heel down at 45. Look forward, inhale, arms forward and up, warrior one. Exhale, interlace hands behind the back. Inhale, pull the hands off the seat. Exhale, hinge and fold to the inside of the front leg. Let's hold it at first. Then I'm going to tell you, we're going to do another round a lot more vigorously. So feel the alignment points. Back heel rooted. Clip your left hip back.
Touch your left temple to your left inner ankle if you can.
Press through the feet, inhale, rise. Sweep the arms forward and up, warrior one. Exhale, sweep the palms forward and down. Step into plank, inhale. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog, puff the heart. Exhale, downward facing dog. Step the left foot in a little. Inhale, reach the right leg up and back, three-legged. Exhale, step your right foot forward. Step the back foot out to the left an inch or two. Spin the heel down 45. Inhale, arms forward and up, warrior one. Exhale, interlace hands behind the back. Inhale, pull the hands off the seat, lift the heart. Exhale, hinge and fold to the inside of the front leg. And again, holding it at first. Anchor the back heel and back pinky toe. Keep hinging right at the hips. Touch your right temple to your right inner ankle, maybe. Inhale, come up. Sweep the arms forward and up, warrior one. Exhale, palms forward and down. Inhale, plank. Level. Exhale, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Flare the toe. Exhale, downward facing dog. Five breaths. One. Keep the breath moving, y'all. Two, minimize restlessness. Three, a lot of us need to roll our upper arms out and back more. So the shoulder blade should not squeeze the vertebrae of the neck at all. Four, hug the forearms in. Five, inhale, step or hop forward. Halfway lift. Now exhale, fold over your legs. Interlace your hands behind the back. Reach the arms overhead. Inhale here. Exhale, bend your knees. Take a chair pose with your hands interlaced. Inhale, stand up. Little back bend. Exhale, neutral. Samasthitihi. Release the bind. Okay, so we're going to do it again faster. I want you to have the opposite crossing, opposite thumb on top every time you bind this time, unless you were alternating actively. All right, everyone there. Samasthitihi. Exhale your air. Inhale, interlace hands behind the back, lift the heart. Exhale, bend your knees, sit in interlaced chair. Inhale, lift the chest. Exhale, fold over the leg with the interlace. Inhale, palms to the mat, set them for chaturanga. Exhale, step or float back, chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog, step the right foot in a little. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, left foot forward. Spin the back heel down. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, interlace hands behind the back. Inhale, arch. Exhale, fold to the inside of the leg. Inhale, rise. Sweep the arms overhead. Warrior one. Exhale, palms forward. Step into chaturanga. Straight there. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Step the left foot in a little. Inhale, right leg up. Exhale, right foot forward, spin the back heel down. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, interlace behind back. Inhale, lift the heart. Exhale, fold to the inside of the front leg. Inhale, rise, sweep the arms overhead, warrior one. Exhale, palms to the mat, chaturanga dandasana. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Five breaths. One, let the breath start to slow down gradually. Two, I think only light stretches. Three, tongue at roof of mouth. Four. Five, inhale, step or hop forward. Halfway lift. Now fold over your legs as you exhale. Interlace your hands behind your back. Inhale, reach the arms overhead. Exhale, find your chair with interlace. Inhale, stand up, little back bend. Exhale, samasthitihi, release the interlace. Good, let's do one more round. Opposite thumb on top, so the easier crossing. Okay, exhale your air. Inhale, interlace hands behind the back, baby back bend. Exhale, bend the knees, little chair. Inhale, let the heart lift. Exhale, fold over your legs, arms reaching. Inhale, palms to the mat, set for chaturanga. Exhale, float back. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Step the right foot in a little. Inhale, left leg up. Exhale, left foot forward, back heel down. Inhale, warrior one. Exhale, interlace hands. Inhale, lift heart. Exhale, fold to the inside of the front leg. Inhale, rise up, reach the arms overhead, warrior one. Exhale, palms to the mat, chaturanga dandasana. Inhale, urdhva mukha svanasana. Exhale, adho mukha. Step the left foot in a little, inhale, right leg up. Exhale, right foot forward, back heel down, inhale, warrior one. Exhale, interlace. Inhale, lift heart. Exhale, fold to the inside of the leg. Inhale, rise, arms up, warrior one. Exhale, palms to the mat, chaturanga dandasana. Inhale, urdhva mukha svanasana. Exhale, adho mukha. Five breaths. One, feel the heart rate. Wrap your breath around it. Two. Three, hear that audible sound. Four, big breath. Five, inhale, step, hop, or handstand forward. Halfway lift. Exhale and fold. Inhale, interlace hands behind your back. Reach the arms overhead. Exhale, bend the knees for a little chair. Inhale, stand up, baby back bend. Exhale, samasthitihi. Now stand for a moment. Feel the breath. Try to hold attention. So this is not the time to be scattered, if we can help it. Even close your eyes for a moment. Feel the prana in the body. Okay. One more breath here. Exhaling. Eyes are open. Inhale, circle the arms overhead. See the thumbs. Exhale, swan dive forward and fold. Take a big halfway lift. Set for plank and then step into straight arm plank. Now, from here, keep your arms bone straight, okay? Tone back the pit of the belly and tuck your chin to your chest. Look for your navel. Flip onto the top of the left foot and then flip onto the top of the right foot. So you're in a toenail plank and then roll into up dog. Roll the thighs forward. Little bend in the elbows. Roll the shoulder heads out and back and lift the heart. Exhale, down dog. Up and back we go. Get even here. So if chaturanga becomes too much or you're injured in your shoulder, that last transition is how you vinyasa every time. Inhale, stretch your left leg up to the sky. Three-legged dog. Square the thigh forward a little bit. Think roll the hip into the socket more. Point the foot. And then as you exhale, curl the thigh to the belly. Cat your back strongly and step the foot forward. Now be on the ball of your back foot. Ascend high onto your fingertips. As you are ready, high lunge. Sweep the arms forward and overhead. And then cactus your arms out to the sides. Micro bend that back knee so you're not in an anterior tilt. Roll the buttocks down, draw the shoulder blades back, and then interlace your hands behind your back again. Think about pulling the hands off of the back leg, puff the heart, inhale, or exhale, lean over your front leg, hop that back foot in a little, get light on the back foot, and then lift the right leg up into toppling tree as you feel ready. Think about squaring the right thigh with the floor. Clip the left hip back. Start to bring your navel towards your front thigh. When you lose your balance, you take standing split. Very good, Marzella. Lower the hands to the floor. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, fold into standing split. Left hand holds the back of the left low leg. Left forearm wraps behind the calf. Let the head hang. Your right glute needs to be on. Engage the buttocks. So squeeze the buttocks to the bone. Let the scapula spread, not squeeze the spine. Point the right foot. Good. Fingertips to the floor. Big halfway lift. Prolong the breath. Exhale, bend your standing knee. Reinforce your right leg, up Look forward. Bring your palms into prayer in Warrior Three. Keep a bend in your left knee. Reach your arms forward and step into high lunge. Ball of back foot and glide upright. Hands are reaching up. Roll the right hip forward and then lower the right knee to the floor. Point your right foot down into low lunge. Find that neutral pelvis. So here's what we don't want is this, with the belly on the thigh. Lift out of the front hip. Take a few breaths here. Push the top of the back foot down, right at the center of the foot. Shrug the shoulders up to lift the ribs out of the low back. Track the arm bones back. Inhale. Exhale, cactus your arms. Oh, keep the back bend, folks. Shrug the shoulders down the back. Bear the heart wide. And then lower the arms down by your sides. Touch the floor by your back knee or not. Let them dangle. You can let the head fall back if it feels good. Hug the knees in a little. Inhale, lean forward. Bring your fingertips in line with your front foot. Ah, breathing. Curl your back toes under and lift the back knee. Rock back a little and plant your palms flat down. Come into three-legged dog. Swing the left leg up. Inhale. As you exhale, set the left foot on the floor. Inhale, roll forward, plank position. Exhale, chaturanga or flip onto the toes. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Good job, everyone. Inhale, extend the right leg up and back. Hold it, please. So square the right thigh forward. So even if the leg is not as high, right, push through the palms evenly. Clip that left hip in a little. Inhale. Exhale, glide your right foot forward. Ball of back foot. See the feet are in the lane of their hip. Lift your eyes. Ascend up, arms overhead. Inhale. Cactus your arms. Square the left thigh forward. Little bend in the back knee is going to prevent you from popping your tailbone. Keep a little bend so the pelvis is level. Interlace your hands behind your back. Awkward crossing. Pull the hands off the seat. Keep neutral pelvis. If you can maintain that and straighten your back leg, all right. But most of us need to keep a bend. Inhale. Exhale, hinge over your front leg. Hop your back foot in a few paces. Bend your standing knee more. And then lean forward and lift your left leg up into toppling tree. Square the pelvis so I could put something on your hips and it won't spill off to the right. Good, Megumi. Start to hinge. Maybe your navel will come to the thigh. Breathe plenty. Generosity. Take standing split and then soonish future. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale and fold. Right hand holds the back of the ankle. Wrap the forearm to the calf. Plenty breath. Oh. Feel free to keep the standing knee bent. Point your left foot. Tim, try to square the left hip down a centimeter more. Yeah, cog the hips in, everyone. All right, fingertips to the floor. Big halfway lift. Bend your standing knee so you get, you know, kind of grounded. Straighten the left leg, lift your eyes, balance and bring your palms into Anjali Mudra, prayer position. Reach your arms forward, step into a high lunge, ball of back foot, arms overhead. Make any adjustments. Roll the left thigh forward and lower your back knee down. Point your back foot onto the floor. And if your knee feels caught, roll it in more. Drop the buttocks down. So think Mula Bandha, low belly engagement two, and then reach the arms up. Now remember, we do not want to have your belly on the thigh. If the belly's on the thigh, we are in an anterior tilt. And that's not good for the back bend or the low back. Okay, so keep reaching up through the fingertips. Push the center of the back foot down. Track your arms back a little more. Inhale. Exhale, cactus the arms. Keep the heart wide. So think, squeeze the shoulder blades back. Shrug the shoulders down. Shrug the elbows down by the waistline. Lower the hands. You'll dangle by the back leg, or you'll tip the heart up, shrug the shoulders down, and touch the floor with the fingertips. Let the head fall back. Hug the hips in a little, hug the knees in a little. Inhale, shift forward. Fingertips line up with the front foot. Ball of back foot, lift back knee. Rock the hips back a little, plant your palms and come into three-legged dog. Sweep the right leg up. Inhale. Exhale, set the right foot down. Down dog. Inhale, roll forward into plank. Exhale, chaturanga or toenails. Inhale, up dog, prolong the breath. Exhale, downward facing dog. Up and back we roll, folks. Get even in it, big breath. Exhale, let it run. Inhale, extend your left leg up and back. Exhale, spin the hip open and bend the knee. Clip the heel towards the glute. And I want you to look under your right arm. Turn your head to the right so you see your right armpit. And clip your right hip back so the right hip is plugged in. It's not splayed out to the side in this version today. Bend the left knee more. And then square the left thigh to the abdomen. Curl it in towards the chin and step your left foot forward. Let's come to warrior two, spin the back heel down, windmill right arm overhead and rise into the asana. Now in warrior two, keep the legs, lower the arms by the sides and interlace your hands behind your back. Everyone with me? Pull your hands off your seat and then lean to the right a little, lean back a little and swing that interlace to the left outer hip. Bring the back of the right hand to the left outer hip. Roll the right shoulder back and turn your gaze forward. Stabilize your eyes on one point. Like I have a coat rack over here, I'm staring at one of my coats, softly. Feel that in the right armpit, chest. Now release the interlace and clamp your right hand onto your left thigh. Sweep the left arm right alongside your left ear, crescent into half bound, reverse warrior. Keep your back leg firm. Gaze over your right shoulder. Inhale, come up. Keep your front knee bent, start to side bend forward. Reach your left ribs over your thigh. Reach your left arm way forward. Lengthen, lengthen, lengthen. Straighten the left leg and lower the fingertips to the floor or hand to the shin. Now hold steady here. Roll the right shoulder onto the back. And with that, turn the ribs open. Turn the tip of the nose up. Scoop the buttocks back. So think about tucking your left front hip towards your back right heel. Lengthen the bottom ribs with that. Two more breaths. Keep growing in it. Now keep the half bind, gaze down. Half bound, half moon. Bend the front knee. Crawl that back foot in several paces. Bring your left thumb slash block a foot in front of the left pinky toe. Drag the right leg in and inhale to lift it up. Flex the foot. Keep your right heel in alignment with your right hip if humanly possible. Hug the left hip in, right? Hug the left heel down and in and clip the left hip back. Flex your right foot on this asana. It'll give it a lot more control. Right toes turn to the right. Good, unwind the top arm, reach the hand up, inhale. Exhale, step into warrior two. Bend the knee, step back, land it. Inhale, send your eyes forward. Exhale, windmill palms to the mat. Ball of back foot. Inhale, three-legged down dog. Reach your left leg up. Keep the leg lifted as you exhale. Inhale, three-legged plank. Bring your shoulders over your wrists. Lift your left leg higher. Hold on. Everyone hold three-legged plank. Engage your left glute and lift the toes to the sky. Pow. Exhale, three-legged chaturanga. Tops of the feet to the floor. Inhale, upward facing dog. Flare the heart wide. Exhale, tone the pit. Downward facing dog. Transition. Well done. Everyone's together today. I love it. Deep breath. Exhale, let it flow through. Inhale, reach your right leg up and back. Three-legged dog. Exhale, spin the right hip open. Bend your knee. Today, look under your left arm. See your left armpit. See how your left hip is kind of over to the left of the heel? Clip the hip in until the hip lines up with the heel. Bend the right knee a little more. Inhale. Exhale, square the right thigh to the abdomen. Bring the knee forward, step the foot forward. Warrior two, back heel down, windmill up to rise. Right foot forward. Interlace your hands behind your back, awkward crossing. Keep your navel pointing, you know, towards the long end of the mat. Pull the hands off the seat. Now lean to the left a little, lean back a little and swing the interlace to the right outer hip. Hook the back of the left hand into the right outer hip and then turn your chin forward over your front shoulder. Keep rolling the left shoulder back as you turn your gaze forward. Steady the eyes. Now I'm looking at a tree. What are you looking at? Soften and look at kind of the bigger picture. Release the interlace, find the half bind, clamp the left hand onto the top of the right thigh, reach the right arm alongside the right ear, half bound reverse warrior, crescent back, see your back shoulder. Is your back knee bent? If it is, straighten it. Firm the quads, bend the front knee a little more. Good, inhale, come up, keep your front knee bent. Start to side bend forward, lengthen your right ribs over your right thigh, reach the right arm, project it way forward. Straighten the right leg and lower the fingertips to the floor by the ankle or hand to the shin. First thing I want you to do is roll the left shoulder head back and spiral the rib cage open. Turn the gaze up, breathing deeply, continually. Ground the front big toe, folks. Push the front heel down and firm the calf so you do not lock the knee joint. Couple more breaths. Keep scooping the right hip towards your left heel and lengthen your bottom ribs with that. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. Keep the half bind, gaze down. Bend your front knee. Heel toe the back foot forward several paces. Front toes are straight, not pigeon-toed. Correct it if they are. Bring your right fingertips slash block a foot in front of pinky toe and lift the left leg with inhale. Hold half bound, half moon. Absolutely fine to keep a bend in the front knee. Flex the left foot. If your fingertips are on the floor, it's all five of them. Good, highly engage the outer hip, everyone. Try to clip that right hip in just like we did in three-legged dog. Unwind the top arm, reach the hand up, inhale, drop the eyes, exhale, warrior two, glide if you can. Yes, inhale deeply, exhale, windmill palms to the mat, curl the back toes under, inhale, three-legged dog, reach the right leg skyward, exhale, prepare. Inhale, three-legged plank. Now hold it for the first one. Shoulders over the wrists. Lift your right leg up. Look forward, everyone. You're in plank with your right leg up. Engage the right glute. Now three-legged chaturanga. Exhale. Inhale, upward facing dog. Pull the heart right through. Exhale, downward facing dog. Tone back the pit. Rise. Please take a grounding breath. Exhaling. Inhale, step or tiptoe the feet between the hands. Halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, rise. Arms circle overhead, palms together. See the thumbs. Exhale, samasthiti. Okay. Hands on the hips. Shift your body weight into your left foot. So really anchor it down best you can. Be upright and curl the right knee into the belly. Reach your right hand down by the inner thigh and catch your right big toe. Peace fingers around the big toe. Draw the right knee up. Scoop the buttocks down. Now open the right knee out to the right. Clip the right hip down again and then see if you can wrap your left arm around your lower back and catch your right thigh like a half bind again. Done a lot of prep, so see if the body will say yes. And then keep your right knee bent or begin to straighten it. Halfway straight totally counts, or you straighten it all the way out to the side. Point the foot and clip your right hip down as you hold. Please stay with what you have. Presence this, look straight ahead. Find your root lock, low belly, scooping back. Now I want you to retrace your steps, bend your right knee, release the half bind, put left hand on hip, track the right knee straight ahead and set the foot down, exhale. Bueno, hands on hips. Ground into your right foot, take your time, there's no rush, all right? As you're ready, curl the left knee into the abdomen. Reach the left hand down by the inner thigh. Take peace dude fingers around the big toe. Draw the left knee up towards your left side ribs. Keep the hip tucked down. Then open the knee out to the left with it bent, yeah? Hand by the inner leg. Sneakily wrap your right arm around your lower back and see if you can get a hold of your left inner thigh, or you know, push your hand into your back. Stay with the bent left knee or begin to straighten. Straighten it out to the side. Your right glute should be on right now. Gaze straight ahead and hold the drishti stable. Keep pushing the top of the right thigh back, folks. So this is emulating bird of paradise. Breathing. Now retrace your steps, bend your left knee. Right hand on right hip. Track the left knee forward. Exhale, set the foot down. Vinyasa, inhale, circle the arms overhead, see the thumbs. Exhale, fold forward, take your time.
Take halfway lift,
vinyasa through or go straight to down dog if you're at your legal limit. Roll through mindfully. Downward dog.
Inhale, stretch your left leg up and back. Exhale, spin the hip open, bend the knee, three-legged dog. Look under your left arm this time and reach your left foot a little further back. Inhale.
Exhale, square the left thigh into the belly and step your left foot forward. Shoom. Now, hear me out. Step your back foot out to the right an inch and spin the heel down kind of like warrior one. Bring both hands to the inside line of the front leg. Bend the elbows and curl your torso down by the inside of the front leg. So if you're really worked, this is a nice place to ground and anchor in. Otherwise, your left shoulder's hooked to your left inner thigh. You can catch the calf and hook it deeper if you'd like. Then reach the left arm behind the back. Reach the right arm behind the back and bind. Left hand will hold the right wrist, okay? Now, you don't want your left shoulder glued to the thigh. So lean your torso to the right a little bit and get it more like the elbow is hooked around the outer thigh, okay? You can stay right here or bend the right knee, rock into the back leg with the knee bent, inhale, and then exhale, step your right foot forward. Lift the toes, point straight ahead, bird of paradise, bend your right knee, come onto the tip of the left big toe, and then inhale and start to stand. Get upright first before you try to straighten your left leg. Pull the bind down, lengthen the back of the neck, and then straighten the left leg if it will go. Try to hold it, please, so I can see. Svagadividasana. Keep the knee bent as needed. Point the left foot. Roll the buttocks down. Inhale. Exhale, bend the left knee, bend both knees, roll the left foot back to the floor. Good, Scott. Keep the bind, everybody. Now listen before you do. Instead of stepping back into the warrior one leg, which is a little harder on the ankle, step into like a warrior two leg. So step the right foot back, spin the heel down, and then pull up to warrior two. Oh yeah. Inhale. Exhale, windmill palms to the mat. I want to show you something. So just drop your right knee down for a moment. Put your hands on your left thigh and watch. If you can't watch from there, get to where you can. So the actual vinyasa will be to go to three-legged dog. We'll exhale, prepare. Now notice what I mean about keeping the left leg up, because I don't know if we fully know our potential here. Three-legged plank. See how the leg is? It's up. This is fine, but this is a possibility too. See what I mean? And then rolling through. Okay, you get the idea. So plant your hands and come into three-legged dog. Sweep the left leg up and back. Exhale, prepare. Inhale, three-legged plank. Hold it a breath or two so you see what I'm talking about. That's what's up. Exhale, three-legged chaturanga. Inhale, urdhva mukha svanasana, pull through. Exhale, adho mukha svanasana. Yeah, I'm being picky. Deep breath. Let it go on. Inhale, extend your right leg up and back, three-legged. Exhale, spin the hip open, bend the knee. Look under your right arm this time. Reach your right foot back a little more. Inhale. Exhale, glide your right foot forward.
Now step your back foot out to the left an inch or two and spin the heel down like warrior one.
We there? Okay, bring both hands to the inside line of the front leg. Bend the elbows and curl the trunk down. So your shoulder drops beneath the right knee. Catch the right calf and tuck your shoulder deeper under the leg. Reach your right arm around your back. Reach your left arm around your back and bind. Right hand holds the left wrist. Same thing, we don't want our shoulders super glued to the thigh. So lean your torso to the left diagonal. Try to slip the left or the right elbow kind of to the outer thigh. And then look forward. Bend your back knee a little. So it's going to shift the weight back. Look forward, inhale. Exhale, step the back foot forward or a couple of steps. Ground the left foot. Come, you know, onto the tip of the right big toe. And then as you inhale, you stand up. For Svagra Dividasana, bird of paradise. Push to the left heel. Try to upright yourself. Lengthen the back of the neck and then straighten the right leg if it will go. Pull the bind away from you. Keep holding. Keep your breath presence. Your left glute is on. Push the top of the left thigh back, Lila G. Inhale. Exhale, bend both knees, hinge, and roll the right foot to the floor. Now, instead of stepping into warrior one, step to warrior two. Step the left foot back. Exhale. Inhale, come up into warrior two. This time we're getting straight to the point. Exhale, windmill palms to the mat. Ball of back foot. Inhale, three-legged down dog. Reach the right leg up. Exhale, prepare. Inhale, three-legged plank. Reach the right leg up. Hold it for a breath so you get the feel. Engage the glute. Yes, Megumi. Exhale, three-legged chaturanga. Inhale, Urdhva Mukha Svanasana. Pull the heart forward. Lift the knees off the floor. Exhale, Adho Mukha Svanasana. Deep breath. Exhale, run it through. Inhale, lift your heels. Exhale, bend your knees, squat down and look forward, belly in. Inhale, hop the feet between the hands. Land on the feet. Lengthen now. Bakasana or crane. Bring your hands about a foot forward of your feet. Hands are shoulder distance. Lift your heels off the floor and bend your knees. Squeeze the inner heels together. Open your knees out like a V. Bend your elbows and curl your trunk between your thighs. Get your knees right on up into your armpits. You know, take your time. If they won't come to the armpits, just hook the shins to the backs of the arms. Bend your elbows if they're not. Look forward, lean into the hands and point the feet to lift them off the floor. Think about pushing your knees into the backs of the arms. Like your knees are gonna reach towards your index fingers. Start to grow your heart forward. Hold it. We don't want the hips super high nor super low. So you gotta push the knees diagonally forward and down. Step or float, Chaturanga Dandasana. Kick back, step back, recover. Vinyasa or just meet and down dog, which is ample. Downward dog. Deep breath. Exhale the air. Now, this is different. We are working up to Bhuja Pidasana or shoulder pressing pose right now. So I want you to frog leap your feet around your hands. Lift your heels. Bend your knees, squat back. I want you to hop your feet to the outside of your pinky fingers or forward of them. Ready? Inhale, frog leap around the hands. Now, arrange your feet as wide as the mat. Bend your knees. Curl your trunk between your thighs. So make sure you have room for your ribs. Bring the hands to the calves. Let your head hang and tuck your shoulders into your inner thighs. Tuck them in really well and then walk the feet in a little. So it's going to kind of pin your shoulders. Tuck your chin and look at your pubic bone and tuck the shoulders in again. Now hug the thighs into the shoulder blades and place the hands on the floor a little bit behind your heels. Hands are outer shoulder distance. Drop your buttocks down and roll your palms into the floor. Lift your eyes. Try to lift your feet up towards the front of the room and then cross your left ankle over your right or right ankle over the left. Now, instead of the Ashtanga version, I want you to grow in it. Straighten your elbows, squeeze the thighs into the arms, and try to kick your feet towards your face. Lift your eyes and hold steady. Bhuja Pidasana. Nice, everyone. Concentrating. Now unclasp the ankles. Keep your knees bent and flex your feet like little frogs. Lean into your fingertips. Try to drag the feet back. Try to balance in crow or step into plank. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga or toenails. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Take a breath or two. Feel that energy in your body moving, alive and well.
Okay, we're gonna take the same frog leap forward and either repeat Bhuja Padmasana or go to Tittibhasana, firefly. Lift your heels, inhale.
Bend your knees, exhale, tone the pit. Inhale, frog leap the feet around the front of the fingers. Feet as wide as the mat. Curl your trunk between your thighs, so knees are bent. Catch the calves.
Tuck the chin and tuck the shoulders in again.
Walk your feet in a little, holding the backs of your calves.
Look at your pubic bone. Tuck the shoulders as deep in the thighs as you can.
Hug the thighs in, and then place the hands on the floor a little bit behind your heels. Roll the palms down, bend the elbows, lower the buttocks, lift your head and lift your feet. Either cross the ankles, opposite crossing, or try to rock your pelvis between your forearms and straighten the legs. Let the feet point as high up as you can. Hold steady. Push the shoulders into the legs as well. Now bend the knees, flex the feet like little frogs, lean forward, swing into crow, vinyasa, skip it as needed. We'll meet in down dog. And then we will take a child's pose. So if you need to go straight there, go straight there. Take child's pose. Pau or Chris, anyone that does not want to rest can take handstand or can repeat the arm balance or can simply rest. Take the weight off your hands. Few breaths. Feel that exhilarating energy. We are in Balasana. Or if you're holding down dog, just know what you're signing up for is just resting in the asana. All right, well, as fun as that was, come back to down dog as you're ready. And from here, you're gonna jump through to seated. So lift your heels, bend your knees, belly in, try to jump into a cross-legged position,
and then swing the feet through the hands. Hover in L-sit,
and then sit. Ah, straight legs. Move the buttocks flesh out and back, please. As you are centered, see the heels are, you know, not off to one side or the other, but they're right down the middle lane. Hinge forward and catch the outside edges of the feet. Bring the thumbs to the bony top of the foot. Pull the pinky toe side back and push the big toe side forward. Shoulders down the back, lift the heart, inhale. Exhale, hollow belly and fold. If it's quite easy to fold, you can take wrist clasp. So if you do that, you lift your head a little. Hook the back of the left forearm to the outside edge of the left foot. Right palm faces forward. Hook the right back of the forearm to the outside edge of the right foot. Left hand holds the right wrist. Arm forearms are closer to the heels, yeah? Big halfway lift if you're doing that. Exhale and fold. Make your breath prolonged. See if you can wrap your breath around your heart rate and use that as a technique to slow the heart rate down. Bend your knees if you need. Let the breath move. When you're left to your own devices, can you remain in that one-pointedness? That is the integrity of the practice. If we really want to see the yoga transform us, we adhere to that integrity. That means the mind will still maybe run, but you keep bringing yourself in, calling into center. Two more breaths here. Make good time with, or make good use of your time.
Inhale, halfway lift.
Exhale, release the feet and sit upright. Now, make sure you have some clearance behind you. We're going to do a version of Paschi from the Hatha Yoga Pradipika. It's called Gat Yat Nak Paschi Motanasana. So move the buttocks flush, feet hip distance. Lean forward like you're doing a sit and reach, and reach your arms way forward of your toes. Now, as you exhale, start to roll back, kind of like you're doing sinking boat. Let your heels kind of pull back. Point your toes, lay all the way back, and reach your arms all the way overhead. Bring the backs of the hands to the floor. Inhale. Exhale, swing the arms forward and sit up. Touch the toes or reach way beyond them. Inhale, start to curl back.
Exhale, all the way onto the back, arms overhead. Flex the feet, inhale, sit up.
Touch the toes or reach past them. Inhale, start to curl back.
Exhale, roll all the way back, arms overhead. Flex the feet, inhale, come up, reach past the toes.
Exhale. Inhale, start to curl back.
Exhale, all the way on the back. Inhale, swing the arms forward and sit up.
Exhale, in.
Inhale, start to curl back. Exhale, all the way on the back, arms overhead. Inhale, swing the arms forward and sit up.
Reach past the toes. Exhale. Do a few more. Inhale, start to curl back. Exhale, all the way on the back, arms overhead. Flex the feet. Inhale, swing and sit up. Exhale, past the toes. Okay, so the rhythm is inhale, start to transition. Exhale, land on your back. Inhale, transition up. Exhale, land in the pose. Keep going. So the pattern is inhale, initiate transition. Exhale, destination. Inhale, transition. Exhale, destination. Do you hear me? Feel me? Inhale, transition. Exhale, destination. Inhale, transition. Exhale, destination. Do two more. If you're dizzy, you stay in the fold. Old school stuff. Make sure your low back is in agreeance. If it's not, stay in the fold. One more. Good. As you come up, catch your feet and fold again. Well done. This is a strong practice, so be loving. You can bend your knees if you need. Please take two more breaths here. You're in the full forward fold. Okay. Pull back on your feet. Take a big halfway lift. Inhale. Exhale, release the feet. Prepare to vinyasa. Cross your right ankle over the left. Scoot forward. Let's have a brief review, please. Wrap your arms around your legs. Hold your elbows in opposite hands. Lean onto the buttocks and balance. So I want to be so clear that if you're not taking the full jump back, this is a really good place to stay. Hold your attention steady. Option two is arms parallel to the floor. Engage your hamstrings and clip the heels towards your butt. So you don't want them way far out. Clip them in. Option three, hands down in front of the outer hips. Lean into the hands. Try to lift your buttocks off the floor. Inhale. Swing the feet back. Step or float into plank / chaturanga. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, down dog. Up and back we go. Deep breath. Exhale the air. Inhale, jump through to seated, opposite ankle on top. Drag through, L sit hover, and sit. Okay, change of pace. Actually, I'm gonna say sideways so I don't confuse you. I want you to swing the feet to the left outer hip. Knees will be hip distance. Rest your left ankle in the arch of the right foot. You can move your right buttocks flesh out and back. And then just place your left hand on your left knee. Look to the right and swing your right arm around your lower back. Grab your left bicep. You can bend the left elbow. Right hand holding left bicep. I know this is, it's so simple, but not. Now reach your left arm up like a little T-Rex arm. Like nah, 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 nah. Start to turn to the right. Twist your trunk to the right. Keep a hold of the bicep and bring the left hand to the right knee, the right outer thigh, and twist to the right. Bharat Vajrasana A. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. Roll the right shoulder back. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. Two more breaths that way. Work on the spiraling of the spine. Keep turning the gaze over the back shoulder. Inhale. Exhale, twist. Inhale, turn your head forward. Exhale, unwind the twist. Take your hands behind your hips, fingertips, lean back, curl the knees in, rock cat the legs up, and then swing the feet to the right hip. Right ankle rest in the arch of the left foot. You can pull the left buttocks flesh out as needed. Knees are hip distance. They can go outer hip distance. Place right hand on right knee. You ready? Wrap your left arm around your lower back and grab your right bicep. You can bend the right elbow as needed. Now keep a hold of the bicep. Lift your right hand up like a little T-Rex arm. Start to turn the trunk to the left, turn to the left, and bring the right hand to the left outer knee. Outer thigh is fine. Good. Inhale, lengthen in it. Exhale, twist to the left. Now keep growing. Every time you inhale, you're just taller in the twist. Every time you exhale, you turn. Twisting to the left. Chris, change the arms. Mm-hmm. So the right arm is reaching across the body. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. Two more, everyone. Roll the buttocks down so we're not in a big back bend. Gaze over the back shoulder. One more breath. Inhale, turn your head forward. Exhale, unwind. Fingertips on the floor, a little behind your hips. Lean back. Curl the knees into the belly. Rock the hips side to side so the buttocks is even. Reach the feet up. We're going to boat. Ready? Lean into the glutes. Lower the legs a little or a lot. Track your hands forward. Reach them parallel to the floor. Gaze at the tip of your right big toe. Five breaths. One, firm the quads. Two, feed the sternum up. Three, squeeze the ankles in. Four, five, cross your left ankle over the right. Stay in Lolasana prep or vinyasa. Inhale, pick it up. Exhale, step into chaturanga or plank. Inhale, up dog. Exhale, downward facing dog. Up and back we go. Next inhalation, jump through to seated, opposite ankle on top. Swing the legs through, hover, and sit. Bharat Vajrasana B. Bend the left knee and put the left foot on the floor. Grab your left ankle and then swivel the left foot into like a half heroes. So the left toes point back. The left heel is by your left outer hip. Okay. Now bend the right knee and bring the sole of the right foot to the inside of your left thigh. So if you don't do half lotus on the reg, this is your pose. Twisting to the right. If you take half lotus, pick up the right leg, cradle it, roll the hip and the knee out and down and place the right foot on top of the left thigh. Place your left hand on the outside of your right knee, twist to the right, wrap your right arm around your back and bind with the lotus, okay? You wanna lean into the lotus leg, the knee should not hover, your left hip will, yes? To ice the cake, flip the back of the left hand to the outside of the right knee. Lift the knee briskly and hook your left fingers under the knee. So you push your left palm flat down. Anyone in lotus should be doing this. Push the left palm into the floor and twist to the right. So again, the lotus knee is not safe to hover here. You need to lean to the right to get the knee down. Keep growing in the twist. As you push the left hand down, roll the right shoulder back and turn. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. One more. Now keep everything, but turn your gaze forward. Feel that stretch the right side of the neck a little. Push the left hand down a little. And then shift to the left a little and unwind the bind. Straighten the lotus leg. This is something we broke down a while ago, most of you were there, so see if we can do it. Bring your hands in line with your middle thighs. Palms are spread. Lean into the hands. You can bend the elbows a little. Lift your buttocks and left knee off the floor. Drag the right foot back towards the left. Clear the arms and step into plank. Take your vinyasa. Down dog when you reach. And as you inhale, jump through to seated. Opposite ankle on top. Swing through. Straighten the legs, other side. Move the buttocks flush. Bend the right knee, catch the right ankle, and bring the right leg into half heroes. Right toes point back. Try to hook your right outer hip to the right inner heel. Externally rotate the left hip. Bring the sole of the left foot to the inside of the right thigh. You can twist to the left here, or bring the left leg into half lotus. Pick up the leg, cradle it. Roll the hip out and knee down. Place the foot on the thigh. Right hand to the outside of the lotus knee. Wrap your left arm behind your back and catch the big toe. Hook the back of the right hand to the left outer thigh and flatten the palm on the floor so the fingers get kind of loved by the knee. Lean into your lotus knee, okay? Here's the deal. If the knee won't come down, just keep working it. Twist to the left. Inhale, lengthen. Exhale, twist. And if the bind is really easy, you may hold the ankle of the lotus leg, yeah? Let the right hip lift, but let the lotus knee hip stay down. Three more breaths in Bharat Vajrasana B. Roll the left shoulder back as you turn. Two more breaths. Keep growing in it. Inhale, turn your head forward. Hold it for a moment. Let your right ear drop towards your right shoulder. So you're opening the left side neck scalenes. Shift to the right a little and unwind. Straighten the lotus leg. Place your hands down by your outer thigh. So see, they're a little forward of my hips, you know, 6 to 8 inches. Lean into the hands. Lift your buttocks, lift your right knee. Lift the left leg or not, but drag it towards the right hand. Sweep it all the way back. Plank position. Vinyasa. Down dog. As you inhale, jump through to seated. Opposite ankle on top. Swing on through, folks. Okay, Baddha Konasana. Soles of feet together and knees wide. Take index and thumb around the big toes. Squeeze the heels in, folks. Rock side to side and feel that start to, how do I want to say this? Lengthen the adductors more. Do it several times. And if it feels good, you can scoot your hips forward towards your heels as you do it. Get even, squeeze the heels together and spread the big toes apart and sit tall. Think about moving your heart forward and up a little. You can stay upright or hinge from the hips and fold. Lengthen forward. Think about elongating through the side ribs and eventually the forehead will touch the floor. And eventually the knees will touch too. Take a few breaths here. Keep the elbows into the side ribs. So if we bulldog the elbows forward, are you reversing a lot of the armpit chest work we did? I don't know. Ask yourself. Make a sovereign decision. Three more breaths. Keep elongating. One day we'll actually feel our sternum come onto the feet and the chin on the floor. One more big breath. Now as you inhale, lift your chest and slowly start to come up. Exhale, arrive. Lift the heart more. Gaze down the body. Big breath. Exhale, release. Lean back a little. Bring the knees in. Cross the ankles. Prepare to vinyasa. Inhale up. Swing the legs back. Vinyasa through. Chaturanga getting too much. Forget about it. Go straight to up dog. And we folks will meet in down dog. Okay, changing directions. Take a breath. Exhale. Lower your knees to the floor. Now, hands are in front of the shoulders by what you deem a forearm's distance. Bend the elbows and lower them to the floor. Interlace the hands. Tuck the bottom pinky into the palm. See that your elbows are a middle shoulder distance apart. Round your spine like a cat and then lift into dolphin. Lift your knees off the floor. Let your head hang.
And before you walk in a lot, push through your forearms and reach your chest back. Feel the shoulder opening element. Now you can stay here, or you can try to walk the feet forward a little more and lift your hips higher. Balls of the feet. Keep walking the feet in and come for headstand. Bring the head onto the floor. The hands cradle the back of the head. Tiptoe the feet in. Rock the hips a little past the shoulders and start to bring the legs up. You can do one leg at a time too, or simply pike the legs up, quote simply. You can go to the wall. If you're holding dolphin, try to hold it for the duration of the headstand. That way you build the energy. People in headstand, I want you to come to bound angle legs, soles of feet together and knees wide. And then open the knees wider so the feet separate and bring the legs into a straddle position. See if you can hold that. Make sure there is more weight in your forearms than your neck. Straddle, people, retrace your steps. Bring the soles of the feet together in bound angle. And then bring the legs straight up. And then do it again. Soles of the feet together, knees wide. Open into straddle. Those of you who are with me on this, hinge at the hip crease and tap your toes to the floor in straddle. Keep the weight in your arms. Keep your shoulders away from your ears. Inhale, bring the legs all the way up. Bound angle. Oh. Exhale, inhale, legs up. Repeat it once more, or time to release. When you're ready, you come into child's. Good, Marzella, way to go for that. Nice, Vic, ribs in. Child's pose, arms to the fetal position vibe, or arms out in front to release the neck more. Those of you who are still working the drill, you know who you are. You could continue and continue and continue. Take a rest though. Probably if you're looking at the camera, you're gonna see me making some adaptations. Get your rest on, folks. All right, come on up. Pull your mat to your wall. If you don't have a wall, can you find a closet door? Anything. So take a moment. You don't have to bring your camera with you because I will demo and then set you free. And let me be really clear. This is not going to be the greatest view. It's not like a workshop view or anything, but you know, welcome to my kitchen. Here's what's up. You'll be able to see at least part of me. So it'll work, hopefully. So you can either work your headstand again, all right, having just more support or more time with it, or we'll work the same type of thing in forearm balance. So I'm going to have my hands either in Dharma Mitra hands, so tips of thumbs together, or if that's difficult, you can do interlaced fingers, kind of like headstand. I roll my elbows in. Please watch, because this is new for some of us too. Cat your back. Melt the heart a little so the shoulders plug in and walk the feet in a little. Now, before you just try to go up, when people do that, they end up here. We want to stretch the shoulders out, okay? So once you feel a decent stretch, the shoulders have landed, make sure the elbows aren't too wide. You're gonna walk in a little, keep pushing through your arms. Reach your easy leg up, presumably. You can do a practice hop. Then as you inhale, lift up. Swing and try to, look at me, speaking of a hypocrite. Swing and curl the knee into the belly. Now you have the wall or not, bring the legs up. Now you can use the wall. And if you're working on going up, that's your work. Otherwise, squeeze in, push through the arm. See how I'm getting more and more length in my side body. For those who need a project, bound angle, anterior tilt, knees wide. See if you can catch straddle. I'm not fully feeling that connection in myself. And rather than take 10 times to show you, you kind of get the idea, okay? So face the wall, lower your forearms to the floor. Have your hands about a foot from the wall, tips of thumbs together. Go a little further if in doubt. All fours on forearms, round your spine like a cat. Now melt the heart a little, curl the toes and lift into dolphin. Walk the feet in a little. Tighten it up. Tim, the elbows need to narrow by about 4 inches. Don't let it be wide. It'll set a bad habit. Lift a leg and come up as you're ready. Reach the leg up.
Bend the bottom knee and push off the bottom leg. Good, Lila. Make sure the forearms are wrapping in. Now, for some of us, going up is enough. Good, thank you. If you have a hard time not splaying the elbows, bring the tips of the thumbs together. It will make all the difference for you. That's it. Good, Scott. Push off the hands. If you want to do the drill, get your balance. That's the prereq. Squeeze the legs in, May. Gumi. That's it, my girl. And then only if you feel it, you come to bound angle. It's a little harder. Think anterior tilt. That's it, pal. After you've done one or two, sit up and rest for a moment. See how all that shoulder binding actually helps this pose? This is an armpit chest pose. Let me show you one more variation. Maybe this will be helpful, maybe not. And if you're like, I struggle with inversions, well, I'm part of that crew too. So tips of thumbs together and wrap, cat back. This is the protocol, okay? Wrap elbows in, cat back, melt heart a little, lift knees. Walk in. You can reach the opposite leg this time as long as it feels secure. You can give a practice run, make sure the shoulders feel good. Swing down, bling up. The hips have to come over the shoulders. Legs come together. Now, if you balance, only if you balance, okay? Think zip to the midline. So I'm really extended here in my shoulders. And hopefully I won't hit my table. Maybe you can go to straddle here. It's all hip flexors. Point the toes, hold it, and then come down. Eventually we'll do several in a row. Why don't we save that for a workshop? All right, one more. Face the wall. Same hand position as last time, unless you're like a master of this pose, you could do whatever you want. Good, Tim. As you're ready, cat your back. If you're taking rest, take supported bridge. It'll help keep the momentum. Reach opposite leg. That's it. Swing and bling, baby. Shoulders over the hips. Hips over the shoulders. There we go, Doc. Think about anterior tilt, Doc. And as you anterior tilt, legs go towards the windows. You'll know when it's been enough. Get your last bit of what you need there. Zip mula. Good, Megumi. I see that. All right, take your time. Nice. Well. Let's come off the wall. Well done. Come off the wall and stand up on your knees when you're ready. I'm gonna make some micro adjustments as well. Doing great, folks. Set up Ustrasana. So we'll stand on our knees. And as you are there, place your hands onto your hips. I know my camera's not great. I'll correct it in a moment. Knees hip distance, feet as well. I like this after pincha. I think it releases the neck. Draw the shoulder heads back and hug the elbows back. Find neutral pelvis. So maybe you need to go between anterior and posterior tilt a few times. I suggest you do, because neutral pelvis is a little different for each of us because we all orientate differently posturally. So find what's neutral for you, what's level. Shoulders back again. Roll the bottom of the sacrum down and in and lift your chest. And then do it again. Move the hips forward a centimeter. Lift the heart up. Keep peeling the heart up. Lift, lift, lift. Let the head fall back. Hands can stay on the hips or arms dangle. Catch your heels at the same time. Every inhale, lift your heart a little. Every exhale, land where you are. Every inhale, lift the heart. Every exhale, land where you are. Two more breaths here. Hands on the hips is totally fine. These look good. Inhale, shift forward. Put your hands on your hips and find neutral pelvis. Standing on your knees, neutral pelvis.
and then sit on the heels. Exhale. Bravo. Okay. From here, transition onto all fours. Crawl your knees back. Round your spine like a cat. Exhale.
Hold it for another breath and think your low back will thank you. And then inhale, arch like cow.
Hold it. Balls of feet. Rock forward and land your chest between the thumbs. Chin on the floor or hovering. Inhale, lay flat. Point the toes onto the floor and crawl onto your forearms. Come into Sphinx. Shoulders roll back. Each leg stretches back. So you're feeling the center top of the quad on the floor. Bend the knees. Try to drag your hips between your arms. Shoulders stay back. Engage the whole back body here. So really squeeze the hamstrings and the calves. Stay right here or reach your arms by your sides. Catch your ankles, one and then the other. Let's keep our feet hip distance. Flare at the toes, so flank the feet. Exhale, anchor pubic bone. Kick the feet back, lift the chest, like camel, and then lift the knees. Keep the feet reaching up, the heart lifting, and hold. Engage the back line of the body. Five, hold it. Four, feel the biceps grow. Three, knees hug in a little. Two, engage the back line. Up dog, lower the thighs, place the hands under the elbows, straighten the arms, inhale, upward facing dog. Exhale, downward facing dog, roll on. Take your time to do it well. Tuck your chin to your chest, try to see your navel. Breath or two, home stretch, folks. Inhale, stretch your left leg up to the sky. Pigeon, curl the left knee into the belly. Touch the left knee to the left outer wrist. Open the foot to the right. Slide the right leg back. Point the back foot onto the floor. One option is to fold forward because you know you're over it. Otherwise, roll the right thigh in. See your right heel in line with the right hip. Crawl your hands onto your left leg. Now, see how I'm pitched forward? We don't want this. I'd rather you hover your hips and find neutral pelvis. So feel that neutral pelvis. Feel the hips drop. Feel right here or bend your right knee. Reach your right hand back and catch the ankle. And then lean forward a little. Reach your left hand back and catch the ankle as well. You can overlap the hands. If they're too sweaty, just one beneath the other. Kick the right leg back. Feel the center of the thigh ground. Square the right ribs forward. Stay here. Anyone who does full pigeon, left hand on left thigh. Look over your right shoulder. Keep your right foot flexed. Flip your right palm up and grab the instep of the foot with the palm cradling the top of the foot. Bend the right elbow, points down. Pull the right foot towards the shoulder. Arch like bow and then flip the right arm. The elbow out and overhead, flipping the grip. Square the right hip and right ribs forward. If you have it, reach your left arm overhead. Catch the foot as well. Maybe crawl the hands down the foot, overlap the hands, and maybe arch back. Foot and head together. Three breaths. Release as you exhale, fold forward with control. Forearms down or arms all the way straight. Big breath, let it go. One more. Lift your head, crawl your hands back, plant them, step straight into down dog. Let's skip the vinyasa, we're warm enough. Inhale, stretch your right leg up and back, three-legged. Pigeon, curl the right knee in, touch the knee to the right outer wrist. Open the foot to the left and slide your left leg back. So ideally, you're gonna do the same thing you did on the other side, all right? See your left heel in line with your left hip. I always have to fix mine, so make sure you're checking in. And then hug the knees in. Hover your butt off the floor if that's what it takes to find neutral pelvis. Hands on the front thigh. So think this
is not neutral pelvis. So hover instead. Arch your heart up. Stay right here or bend the back knee. Reach left hand back, hold outer ankle. Lean forward, pull the leg in, reach right hand back, hold inner ankle and overlap. Kick the foot back. Square the left ribs forward so you can gaze down the body and see if that's happening or not. Ground the center of the femur, center of the thigh. Anyone who took me up on the last option, right hand on right thigh, look to the left without flopping onto your right butt. Flip your left palm up, grab the instep of the foot. The palm cradles the top of the foot. Now draw the foot towards the shoulder, arch up and back. Flip the left elbow out, forward and overhead. Fold as you're ready, of course. Square the left ribs forward. Reach the right arm up and overlap your hands. Good, everyone. Wherever you are, land in it. People who are in this last backbend expression, keep squaring the left ribs forward. Three, two, and if you're in the backbend, release with control and fold forward. Take your time. Oxygenate. Climb onto your palms. Prop up. Step into down dog. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Inhale, roll forward into plank. Exhale, lower your knees. Inhale, arch your spine like cow. Are you with me? Exhale, chest between the thumbs. Inhale, lay flat. All right, stretch each leg back a little. Feet outer hip distance apart so you can look over a shoulder, see that that's going on. Last pose before we cool it and chill. Place your hands halfway between the shoulders and the elbows for cobra. As you exhale, anchor your pubic bone. So roll the bottom of the sacrum down and in. Feel how that pushes the hips down. Grip the hands down. Don't move the hands at all, but feel like you're going to drag them back and start to peel into cobra. Keep the thighs rooted, the toes rooted, tops of the feet rooted. Roll the shoulders back. Make sure you feel even. If this feels really darn good, you're able to keep the heart wide and straighten the arms. I want you to bend your elbows and roll down a little and then bend your knees. Pulse forward and back a few times so the hip flexors get unstuck and then hold it. Roll the shoulders way back. Big armpit chest pose. Maybe come onto your fingertips. Think about pushing the thighs down. Shoulder blades squeeze back. Puff the heart, let the head fall back. Reach the feet towards the head. Breathing deeply. Keep the hamstrings talking. Look at the third eye. And then gently release and roll down. Hoo, 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 rest. Pillow your hands under your forehead. Breath. Raja Kapotasana pose. King Cobra, Queen Cobra. Hands under the shoulders. Push to all fours, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. So that, my friends, is an armpit chest class. Take a breath or two. And then we'll come to seated. Lower down or jump through. Recline onto your back. Hug the knees in. I am not planning on teaching Urdhva Dhanurasana. I know there's a few of you who have an Urdhva Dhanurasana love affair. You can take a few on your own. I won't be offended. That's wheel pose. Otherwise, you're hugging your knees in. And open the arms out to the sides. If anyone's taking wheel, you ignore me and you go for it. Otherwise, knees are hugged in, curl the knees in, open the arms out to the sides, palms up. Reach your feet straight up to the sky.
Use your core and swivel your buttocks to the left a couple inches. So you come onto the right outer hip, squeeze the ankles and lower the legs into the right hand. If you need to do it with bent knees, hey, I love you, I support you. So here's the deal. When you scoot your hips to the left, you twist the legs to the right. That way your hips are in line with your shoulders when you twist. Why is that important? So the twist is not only in your lower back. Good, clip a little bit of each foot with the right palm. Gaze to the left. If you're in Urdhva D, do as much as you need to clear your energy field. It's essentially what that asana does. Concentrating. All right, hug the ankles in, tone the pit. Inhale, bring the legs up. Use your core, scoot your hips to center. Scoot your hips to the right a couple of inches. So you're going to come onto the left outer hip and then lower the legs over into the left hand. Clip a little bit of each foot with your left palm. Hold steady. Turn your gaze opposite of the twist. Let the breath in. That was a big one today. Make sure you're nourishing yourself with your breath. Squeeze the legs in, ankles in. Inhale, bring your legs up. Good. Center your hips using your core. Bring your palms down by your hips, head straight. Inhale, go all the way to plow. Push the hands down, reach your feet all the way overhead. Bring the toes to the floor behind the head. Interlace your hands behind your back. Roll the shoulders under. Take a few breaths. So this is to release the back, not necessarily to do a shoulder stand cycle. For that, we require blankets usually. Megumi, push your feet into the wall. That will be fine. Toes curled is easier. Toes pointed is more intense. So please discern. Feel the elbows push into the floor. Gorgeous. Flip your palms down so you release the interlace. And I want you to roll out vertebrae by vertebrae to our destination of Shavasana. Push the head into the floor. Push the hands down, palms down, unless you're doing your own thing. I get it. Roll out so slowly that every moment is like, I'm alive. I'm in this body. Oh. And when your feet land, it is well time to rest. If you need anything else before you rest, it is your freedom to be in your own autonomy here, your own independent thinking. Get warm if it's cold, West Coasters. Definitely do take Shavasana. So even if you have to roll, even just taking a couple minutes is good. Get yourself to where you can be. Covering the eyes is really helpful. I cover my eyes every Shavasana ever. Especially those of you who are really pitta, really fiery, really extroverted or busy all the time, you should cover your eyes. And the one thing we always want to make sure we're checking in with is that we are truly comfortable. So do you just land perfectly right away? No. Is that reality? No. Do you sometimes have to adjust your low back or your neck? Yes. Take a decompressive breath. Maybe a sigh. Swallow to release the throat. Let the cheeks be hollow. Relax the eyes deeply back. The back of the head heavy.
Release the neck, the shoulders. The arms. The palms of your hands. Feel the whole back body, the back muscles soften down. And relax your hips. Unwind the pelvic floor. And the legs spiraling down with gravity. Relax the soles of the feet. Allow yourself rest. Perhaps that is one of the most revolutionary ideas of our time, is to leave the to-do list for a while and be in rest, authentic rest, guilt-free rest, indulgent rest. In San Francisco, we call that decolonizing our mind. Does that resonate with you? Please land. Feel yourself lying there. If you would like to stay much longer, please honor that. If you are ready, begin to deepen your breathing. And wiggle your fingers and your toes. Stretch the body full length. Reach the arms way beyond the head. If you want to stay longer, it's all good. You should. Curl the knees in, one and then the other. Roll to your right hand side. And bring yourself upright. Take a seat. As a seat is established, once it is even, bring the palms together, the center of the heart. Let the heart be buoyant and bow the head towards the heart. Offer it up. What are you calling in? Who are you calling into your heart? With those prayers right in the surface of our awareness, let's chant our closing mantras. Exhale all of your air. Inhale for Om. Shanti, shanti, shanti. Namaste. Thank you, dear ones.